गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अप विद आवर न्यू चैप्टर विच इज चैप्टर नंबर 4 एंड इट इज रिलेटेड टू द इवोल्यूशन ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट एंड कम्युनिकेशन. नाउ इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न मोस्टली अबाउट हाउ ट्रांसपोर्ट सिस्टम इवॉल्व्ड और हाउ अ डिफरेंट मीन्स ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन स्टार्टेड इन टू आवर ह्यूमन लाइव्स एंड in what way, in how, and in what gave the discovery of an important thing which is known as wheels. Because of this discovery of wheels, how human life changed in regarding to transport and communication facilities that we are using in our modern times also in a more advanced way. Now, as we had discussed in our previous chapter also, I had given a few small brief detail about the discovery of wheel, which was most probably done in the Neolithic period, where it stated about how the idea or the emergence of wheel took place. Now, and in this chapter we are also going to learn about, as time went on, how a human being developed this concept of wheel into a better way and various different important or advanced means of communication started to be developed in our modern times, and each of them had an important significance in different ways into our lives, which is still existing in today's time. Now, first of all, we'll have to understand as to how did the evolution of transport system started. Now, earlier in our previous chapters also, when we were learning about the early human beings, we had studied that people had no way of communication. They did not know how to speak. They had no knowledge about language. But and as well as when they used to travel from one place to another, they used to go by walking, mostly barefoot, with their own feet, which took them a very long time, and which was very tiring. But as the days went on, there were various different developments that took place into the human life of the earlier people. And that was the time when, most probably by experiments and observations, these were the two important things that most probably the early human beings used to bring about changes into their lives. And this is how the concept of wheel also started. It was considered that earlier people used to carry things on their own body weight, which was very tiring, exhausting, and they had to pull those things for a very long distance, and which took a very long period of time, or it was time consuming for them. But slowly, when time went on, it was seen that people started dragging things, holding and dragging. So that concept gave them an idea as to use logs or things which can be frictionless, which could be easily pulled by them. So they started using logs or wooden pieces joined together, and they used to drag them, which is known as sledges, made out of wood. Then slowly, again they conceptualized a different form, which was bringing about round logs, or a trunk of wood was cut, or a tree was cut, which was taken into small pieces, and it was put, while pulling, it was put one after the another, and it was transferred, things were transferred on them. Now this became more easier for them, as it was less friction, and slowly they evolved into a more better idea, that is cutting those round logs into small circular pieces and then attaching them into the things that were carried. So what they started to do is that they made wheels, round circular wheels, which was less friction, which had less friction on the ground, and it was pulled easier. Again, a more developed concept started. It is that they started thinking, why not make this wheel in such a way that it rotates by itself, it circulates, so that it is not required to be, there is no kind of friction on the ground totally. So they started making axles and adjoining things with this circular form. And this is how it was said that wheels got discovered. And then when things were easier for them to carry from one place to another, initially it is said that human beings used to pull them. But later on, animals like cows, buffaloes, horses, donkeys, they were attached to these carts, wooden made things, and it helped them to pull more easier. Not only things that were carried in this form of transport earlier, but human beings also started traveling on them, which made their transport system more convenient and easier for them to transport, go from one place to another. So this is the history or the details about how exactly the discovery of wheel or existence of wheel came into the human life. Now, the evolution of this wheel brought about many changes. As I told you now only that initially it was used for mostly for carrying people from one place to another. But later on it was seen that even human beings also carried themselves, as it was pulled by animals, the domesticated animals that previously people used to keep in their homes. So these domestic animals were used in this works for them to make easier for transport system, which was easily carried or it was pulled. Heavy loads were pulled easily. So this most probably helped in various different evolvement or evolution of wheel, which brought about different inventions into the life of people using this concept of wheel. And this is how this evolution or discovery has given us an immense kind of turnover into our lives, which had benefited us in many, many different ways. Now, considering this, there were different people who, because of this wheels discoveries, different kind of machineries were built up. Now, it was called, regarded long time back, that ships were made. And it also had wheels on them to turn around, so that the heavy ships that were made, it could move from on the water bodies from one place to another easily. Now, on that concept, there were various different voyages that took place. Voyages in the sense people started traveling from one place to another in ships. Now, this traveling from one place to another also brought about a lot of importance. How it brought about a lot of importance, you can see here that people started discovering new things, new world, new places, new significant things were developed during this time, where people started moving from one place to another in ships. And in these voyages and trade system, this brought about more development in human lives, where new places were discovered. Now, in this chapter, we are going to learn about some of the important people who traveled from one place to another, bringing about a lot of discoveries. And discoveries not only of things, but also different important places, where later on, people started settling down. And a new form of land or a city, a town or a place or a country got discovered during that time. Now, why were these voyages being done by the earlier people? Initially, what was the main concept of people during that time traveling from one place to another in ships in voyages? Now, the main concept or the main idea was for trade and business relationships, to build about trade and business relationships. Now, this trade and business relationship in mind got discoveries, inventions, and exploring ideas of different people in the later part of the period. where initially it is so told that road waves and other land waves were there, but sea waves or the sea routes were considered to be a kind of traveling system where people could travel a very long distance, long distances, covering one landmass to the another landmass, and it was easier rather than on roads, which was more time consuming. So when for trade and other purposes people used to travel from one place to another, new lands were discovered. We can see in our books also, when we go through, that important people names were given here. For example, Vasco da Gama. Vasco da Gama was a very important explorer. We find it in various different history books or knowledgeable books that is written about him, who had brought about a lot of discoveries of different landforms or different new islands or places where at presently settlements are there, giving them new names that were discovered. Now it is said that Vasco da Gama was the first person from Europe who brought about a sea route which connected the European part of the world to India. He was the person who discovered the sea route to India. And he also sailed towards South Africa, where he discovered an important place which he gave name as the Cape of Good Hopes. And as the time passed on, there were various different discoverers or explorers who started traveling, like Marco Polo, who traveled during the 13th and the 14th century. And during his traveling period, he discovered a new landmass which was known as Venice in Europe. And he connected a sea route, he discovered a sea route from Venice to China. So, as more people started exploring, important other people like Christopher Columbus, we might have heard this name. Christopher Columbus was there, Ferdinand Magellan was there, who went across different part of the world. Now, an important thing is mentioned about Ferdinand Magellan is that he was the person who first admitted or first discovered and told that the earth, which was considered to be flat in nature, was not flat, it was round. Why? Because it is said that Ferdinand Magellan had left Europe with his 8 different ships, and he traveled all across the globe and again reached to his same place. But unfortunately, it is said that Ferdinand Magellan died during his own sea route travel, but one of his ships reached back to its home place, and that is the time. Before that, only Ferdinand Magellan had explained the theory of how and why the earth was considered to be round or circular in shape. So each and every people during that time who explored in the sea routes brought about new discoveries, new inventions, and new things that evolved into their own minds, which were told by them to the people. And this knowledge have immensely given us importance in understanding the science, the knowledge about the nature and etc. Now, these important people like Christopher Columbus, Vasco da Gama, Ferdinand Magellan has its own importance in the history, and who brought about a significant importance into the settlement or life settlement of people in different part of the world. Different colonies were established, different new landmasses were established, where people from European part of the world started settling down into a new landforms and creating a totally different place. Like it is said that Christopher Columbus, when he traveled from Europe, he settled to a new island state where he formed 13 states in the coastal part of that island, which is now called as the United States of America. And this place slowly got filled up with more and more population, developed later on the part of the stages of life, and then it gave a new name to be discovered, and a new nation was altogetherly discovered. So every important explorer who traveled during the earlier time in 13, 12, 13, 14 centuries, they had importance that were brought about, and their discoveries and their inventions or findings gave us a lot of knowledge about what existed and how it existed and how it took place. So this is today, for this today's topic. Till now, we'll be discussing more about this particular chapter in regarding to how this transport system, which was evolved with the starting or a discovery of a wheel by the early people or the early humans, has transformed into a new modern system where different kind of modern transport and communication system have evolved in the present times, and how it is used, and what are the different type of forms of transport and communication system that we use in present times. So this is about the chapter. Before ending up, I would like to inform the students that today I have uploaded a link which is in regarding to your test connected to your chapter number 1. The link that is given there, you need to click on that link. A page will be opening where you optional questions are there and question answers are there. In that optional questions, you'll have to select the options direct by opening the link. Going to the question answer part, you'll find an answer column there, blank space there. You'll have to type your answers there, write the answers properly, and go to the submit button at the last part of the page and submit it. On submitting it, those answers will be getting a link. Kindly copy the link after submitting your answers and send it to your groups along with your names, and individually it will be checked, and then it will be responded back as to which student has scored how many marks. Thank you very much, and hope and wish that everyone is staying healthy, and you are keeping yourselves secured in this pandemic period. I hope to see you healthy and fine. Thank you very much.